Hello Dreamers, welcome back to Natalia 101 tutorial tips and tricks, and I welcome you all because today we're gonna have some fun project to do. Not exactly project, but I like to prepare you for the new releases of 2.0 new canvases. And before that, I just like to say, if you happen to be just now discover this channel for yourself, please don't forget to subscribe. Also, hit the notification bell. Not many people know that YouTube sometimes hide in channel. So if you hit that bell, that in the corner, that way YouTube will let you know when new video will come out on this channel. And this is very comfortable. If you are busy, you forget, and you want to see certain video, you always will know the new channel, new video, already up and playing, and you're not gonna miss any important announcements or reviews or tutorials DIY with Anna. So please do so and give me thumbs up if you like this video, of course, on the end. Now guys, before we start my tutorial, I just wanna say that, sorry, it's still old releases gonna be. We will work on the old canvas, but with new one in the help. And we gonna chat a little bit, not much, unfortunately, as I'm a person that is really open, but I cannot tell you too many secrets yet. I will tell you something, but not too much. But if you remember our old releases and we compare our new one, that is, you can see it's a huge difference, right? On the size, it's a big difference on the size. So I would love you to prepare for this new releases, but give you some tips. If you are new and you just started diamond painting, it could be, you know, when you receive this kind of big canvas, and it's not just as big as tall this box, also when you unroll, this canvas even longer than this box, okay? I just wanna warn you that you will love it. So today video will be how to work with huge canvases if you don't have enough space in your house. Maybe you were working on a dining table, all of a sudden you remember there is a dinner time and you need to feed your family. You have to pull out your diamond paint and put away, and not everybody have a big desk to work on or craft table. So today I will give you some idea how you can work on big canvas on little space. Also, we will drill together on one of my older canvases, and then we will chat a little bit about new releases as well. I will tell you maybe some secrets, not many, but whatever I can, I will. And this should be very interesting video. Guys, I hope you're ready. Let's go and do some tutorials. Well, my dreamers, let me help you a little bit to give you a good tip and some tricks how to work with big canvas. And I would love to prepare you for this, because when you will receive a canvas from Dreamer Design 2.0, our new designs, it's gonna surprise you as much as you think you know the size. But when you compare, so I have in here, we're right now at my desk, the big computer up there, and so there's not much really space in here. If I look on this mat that I have in here, it's 60 centimeters long in here, so maybe like I would say 70-80 centimeters space I have on this table, plus I have my light in here, so it's kind of like a crowded, right? And this is the biggest canvas that we have right now. This canvas is 40 by 50 Forgotten Memories, okay? And I just want to show you an example of this. So if I fold the back, not fold, the roller. So we have a long way of canvas gonna be here, and this is shorter way. So this is half canvas tall, okay? So this was our biggest canvas that we had. just gonna, not to spill too much beans, I'm gonna put in here new canvas that you will have when you receive new. Do you see how much longer that is? I hope you can see the shot. So this is not even the longest side of this canvas. This way is, but I am not gonna roll it because I am not gonna spill the beans, guys. I already finished this canvas. It's all done and waiting for you to reveal, but I will wait till we launch our new stuff in the store first. So I will show you example of this one, smaller canvas, how I work, and then I just pick some other canvas that totally not Dreamer design, but it is gonna be long canvas, so I will show you how I work. But if I show you this brand new canvas this way, you can see it's sticking out way further, all the way to my window, and it's kind of like two sides is hanging off my desk. So if I push all the way to the edge of my table, it's touching my window on the other side in here, and kind of like a hanging on the air. So this canvas is huge, and it's even longer. You can see in here, if I put this way, this canvas go from the edge of my table, almost like it's overlapping my computer, because my computer is in here, it's go there. So if I unroll this canvas horizontally the way it's supposed to go, it will go all the way on the top of my computer and hang out of my table like for another maybe like 25 centimeters or so, because it's huge. So let me show you how I work on smaller space with big canvas. First, I'm gonna show you the old canvases that I have. If I can put in here, let me just put my new canvas away. And if I work on this one, usually I put in here and I just put my lamp on the top, and it's more than enough for me room to work on a canvas. And I was just working with this blue one. And it's enough room in here on a little space. But now, what to do if you have big canvas and you don't have a room enough, maybe you don't even have a computer desk, you have a little table. But let me show you what I usually do. I have in here a little helper. I'm just gonna reach it. This canvas is not from Dreamer Design, but I would love to show you as an example. So let me just unroll it because it's a little bit long. So that will give me kind of like visually to show you what you can do. Okay. This is few panels of the canvas, and you can see it's long, right? Okay, so if you don't have enough room and it's gonna like a hang off the table in here, what you can do, you can place, of course, this sideways and let this piece fall off your table. For example, leave it behind up there. You just push behind your table so it's leaning over. But if you have a pets in a house, the probably fur will stick to the pieces in here, and you want to keep this safe. So what I do, I would roll back this way or the other way, it doesn't matter. If you have no diamonds yet, you can roll the other way. I would roll my canvas a little bit. And then you can find at the dollar store this kind of pins. I know it's not very comfortable in here because I shooting this against my window, so the light not as bright. But the idea of it, you pin one side in here, and this one, this another example that I want to show you. You can use those pins from supplies from your school supplies, those pens for the documents, forever, from Staples you can get them, from dollar store as well. You can pin this on both sides so it's keep as sturdy, right? You can roll even more. And then you put your canvas on a table and you have a room to work with. When you're done with one side of the canvas, you simply roll this side and switch to the other side. Now, if you like to start from the top and go down, what you can do, here is my keyboard, you can see. I can push my keyboard further on my lower table, the one that go in and out. And I would put my canvas laying down on my keyboard and start from here and go this way. Okay, so there's a few little different ways how you can do, and I think this idea is great to work with the big canvases. If you don't have a pad, that's okay to actually roll side like in here and the other one just let hang over your table this way maybe. Now, what you can use if you don't have, let's say, you don't have a computer desk, your dining table is busy because family need to eat. What's the solution could be for the bigger canvases if you don't have a big table? So let me show you different example. So here is another way what you can use for your diamond painting or basically any craft if you wish. If you have maybe you have this foldable table, then you can fold and it's easy to put away because you can simply just fold like this and store somewhere away. It's flat, go behind your furniture, whatever you wish. So my little girl using this table for her craft needs, and if you put your diamond painting on it, you can see it's kind of this one, good size of the diamond painting. It's 40 by 50, and you can work on it. But it's still, if I can get to the end, that piece is like gonna be hanging down. So for that, I have a great solution for you guys. If you can go to a dollar store, you can purchase here, just not to kick the camera, huge board, and here is what kind of board that is. Bulletin board for your notes. If you can put this board on the top of this table, automatically you have huge table to work on it. Look how much room you have now. And to tell you the truth, guys, now I can even unroll this brand new diamond painting and it's almost as size as this board, because it's big, it's fit almost perfect. So I can even work with this big canvas on a, such a little table. All I need the help is the little board from a dollar store. And I got this board for $4 in our Canadian stores. And US stores, you're probably gonna be get very cheap. And this is very good quality wooden boards around that. And I think if you can sit down comfortable up there on a sofa, turn TV or YouTube channel and watch our videos and drill at the same time, I think this will really help for those who don't have lots of space in a house. And when you done your diamond painting, you just put everything away and you are ready next day to unfold in few seconds and you're ready. I hope this will help you. So here is my another setup for this video and a little bit different. I will try to record video with different position of my camera. Usually my camera stands on a desk up there where my light is right now, the night light stand. I will try to record this video. I'm gonna put tripod next to me, my chair gonna be here, and here is the lamp that, guys, I did review on it on my personal channel, and this is really game changer because we all know the older we get, our vision not that greatest anymore, and those tiny squares of symbols and diamonds sometimes can be challenging to see, right, without glasses. So this one has a magnifier, has an extra magnifier even for reading if you want to. But I mean, this is such a great idea. You can do this on the floor, as I have a stays on the floor, or you can have one piece out and do this on a table, which you can see this in my video. I explained when I assemble this lamp. So this is something else that really can help you. And right now on my computer, as you can see, our Dreamer Designs video channel. If you please subscribe if you're not yet, and I will watch new video created by Anna. So I didn't watch the video yet, but please, there's a whole bunch of video up there, Anna and mine and Kaylin. So please, if you did not subscribe yet, more than welcome. Okay, so now let's drill together. So now we're gonna work together with you with my magnifying light, and you are watching me from same position that I work. Usually my canvas with camera pointed out from this way, and that's most of my video. You kind of watching upside down my image. Now I place my camera next to me, and because this magnifier glass have lots of light, you can see bright video. I hope it's bright. Let me just check. You can see very well, and at the same time I can see very nice those diamonds now, nice and big, not as small as you see them with your own eye. And you know, the symbols now more clear as well, because it's magnifying in so many times. So this is something, definitely tool that will help you and will be a game changer for your diamond painting. It's very nice now. I can see everything. Now I don't need the glasses, I think. I do not own one. But I think with this helper magnifier lamp, I can do my craft now much better, will be much straight, and also I will see any little bits of fiber that will stick to my canvas or pet's hair. Definitely now I can see very well and I can pick it up. And I already see that stuck to the end of my canvas on a washi tape. And I can pick it up right now. See, that's how good this lamp is. So I created, this is the iron bench, and I outlined last night everything. So now it's kind of like nice that we can fill in, and also we can use technique that we learned before as a checkerboard. Lots of you like this technique. It's fun, and it's even more fun later to fill in them with the other beads between them. You can hear some clicking noises when they go in a place. That's kind of fun as well. And because I do not have a diamonds place like in here under, I always use my parchment paper to secure my tray with drills on it. Also my wrist, my hand, I'm holding the tray and I'm not sticking to the canvas. Now let me know, please, in the comments, if you like this position of the camera better, or if I do place my camera from this side. What is the best view for you? Because it looks like it's more on an angle right now, unless I can pull my canvas a little bit more close
towards you. I don't know. So I would love to know your opinion on this. And I just like you cannot wait to see all the new designs that we will have in the store very, very soon. Of course, if you follow me on social media, guys, that you know I was the one first girl who received new 2.0 version of diamond paintings, because I need to create videos for you with new canvases. So yes, I am very, very lucky girl. And also Anna and Kaylin, because we are the YouTube video creators, and that's why we've received our painting kits, diamond painting kits, sooner, because we have to create video, we need to review. And yes, I finished my canvas already. So the time that you will watch this video, it will be like a week away already. I finished. It took me much longer to do this time than was first designs, like this one, right? Because in here, of course, what we have, let me count colors. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20, 21, 22. So this canvas, Forgotten Memory by Anne Marie Bone, it has 22 colors and old 1.0 version of the diamond painting. Now the new one that I just finished, it has or 52 or 53, I can't even remember now. It's, of course, it's huge, and you saw how big that is, and it's just gorgeous. It's so many colors that, of course, you're not gonna do as fast as I thought I would. No way. It took me much longer, guys, to do this time, but the result, the end result is amazing, and I cannot wait to share with you. Unfortunately, it's only will be on my channel and here after we launch our designs, and I'm just dying to see all the designs. I know some of the artists, their work art are gorgeous, and I know many of you will be in love with these diamond paintings. So what kind of hint I can give you here? I think I got the permission to tell that the shipping gonna be worldwide. Yes, everybody would love that. So how we doing there? You can see me well? It would be good to move a little bit canvas more, or maybe just peel this parchment paper, and I'm just gonna move. I'm still not sure if you're gonna, if you like this position of the camera or not. You really have to, guys, let me know. So I created video with new unboxing already for my channel. I did some work in progress together with you on camera till maybe about the half of the canvas, and I will post that video as you will see new video on Dreamer Design channel first, and then you can hop in and watch another beautiful unboxing on my channel. So it's gonna be a kinda in same day, I think, two different designs you will see from me. And guys, I was working really, really hard to make sure I finish canvas so I can show you finished canvas, the first scoop of the new designs so you can see how that look like. It's so amazing. And I have to say right now that I do have leftovers of all the colors. I did not run out of any of them. And if you follow us on Facebook, that you probably watch already video live stream by Kaylin, and she's already announced that it's 52 new designs. It's amazing. I cannot wait. I know you've been waiting for so long. Some of you almost ready to give up, but I'm telling you, it's worth to wait and worth to save some money. That's all I can say. Okay, as you can see, we are doing good in here. And I'm gonna show you now from the point view what I see through the lens of my light lamp. So I'm gonna gently lift my camera, guys, and I'm gonna show you what I'm seeing. And if you're hearing of right now noises of my camera, on my computer, it's actually loading new video for you. So let me lift up my tripod and I'm gonna show you what I see. And here it is. Okay, I'm just gonna move my chair. Okay, so here it is, what I see through my light. It's nice and bright. And if I go in here under, you see how far those diamonds and those symbols, so it make a big difference. And if we go again, boom, that's what you're gonna see, very close, very clear, and enough light to actually see all your, like, very, very clear.
So what do you think? Do you think this video would help you? If so, please let me know in the comments below. Tell me if you knew already this trick, and surely I already posted some of this on my own YouTube channel, Lovecraft Forever. You might see that tutorial up there as well a long time ago. But because we have new subscribers every day and not everybody looking to older video that already kind of stashed on the bottom, and I would highly recommend you to go all the way to the bottom of this channel and look for beginners, because believe it or not, people still don't know how to put wax into the pan. I have all this cover in my previous tutorials, guys. You just have to go and look. Please subscribe to this channel, give me thumbs up if you like it, and I cannot wait to our new video with this beautiful baby that you will absolutely love it. This is the finished canvas of a new 2.0 release. Beautiful, you will love it, I'm telling you. Save your money, guys. I love you, and on this note, I will say goodbye to next time. Sparkle diamonds for you from me.